Alright, there's the back so far without the shock. Let's see, let's go ahead and put the rear casters on. Oh, doggone bearings keeps falling out. Right. Well, they really don't matter because either way you go, they're going to be the same. So. Now with these, they did come with the right hardware. There's little pins with the clamps, I call them. I don't think they'll stay in there, but we'll give her a shot. Now these wee little pins. How it goes on. The bearing faces further away. This one is like sunk in. You want to make sure this is out on the outside, the bearings. And there's two different setting holes. I'm going to put it in the very first hole. I'm going to try to get these little C clamps on. Man, them things are little. Yeah, if we want to have something to needle nose pliers. Yeah, there it is, little. There, you guys hear it click? And do one for the other front. That and fell off in my hand. I don't think these are going to be very good set up with these. How these got it. I could put some heat shrink tube around it so it won't fall off. See that one, that pin come off. See if that one falls off. And do one for the other side. Yeah, see the different holes in the bottom. I put mine in the very first hole towards the bottom. Squeeze it together a little bit. Then the bearing just fell out again. There we go. That one's still in there. The bearings popped out of it somewhere. Both of them just fell. You know, I'm just going to wait to put the bearings on last. And the linkage arms, guys, I tell you what, these are from GPM. I mean, these things are meaty. They're probably about as thick as a pencil. I mean, they feel really, really, really good on there. And they did come with the hardware. Ahead, get these mounted up so the arms won't quit flipping and flopping. I'm just going to start them in or put them in the first hole right now just to hold them up. Then we can adjust them later. And guess what? I forgot to put the axle in. I guess you learned from your mistake. And the axles I do have, I did take them from my other truck. Because they are steel, and this is what we're going to be using today. Thank you. put the strut tire or the strut board back on there. Well, not up there, but down here. Air won't be flopping around so much now. There. Then we'll do the same for the other side. They got these little pin screws for the axles that goes through the shaft, that way it won't spin. We'll go ahead and drop those in there. I think I'm gonna put some Loctite on it, a little dab. I'm using the blue 242. Just take a drop. Alright, where'd you go? There you go. That's a good boy. Okay, dokie, let's go on to the next side. And the axles, there is a difference. There's a front and a rear. And the... Huh. Let me check on my head truck. I think the back, or the longer one, is for the back, I think. Thank you. put a bit of Loctite on the little screw pin. Whoa, that fell out. Ooh, too much. I think the hose lined up here. Yeah, I don't know why the screw pin ain't fitting in that hole. The other one went in, I don't understand it. It fits in there. No problem. Now there we go, that one went in. put the bearings back into the rear arm now. There's one, two, buckle your shoe. These arms, they're awesome. I really like them. This cause how meaty they are. Well, there's the back. It's pretty well done. Like, see, I got really adjust the camber stuff in it. Alright, see, let's get ahead and start the front. The front is a little bit more complicated, I think. But put these there so I won't lose them. My stand's magnetized. Make sure I'm not forgetting anything in the back. There's a couple of screws there I gotta get put in. Let's see, longer. Yeah, I gotta tighten them back up. A couple screws goes right here. Must be the wrong ones. I can do it here later. I'll find the right ones later. Back up properly.